Welcome back to Let's Play the Outer Worlds, Peril on Gorgon. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We want to go up here to get one of these. What is it again? A phonograph in Birdie's apartment outside OCI. The thing is, this is higher, I believe, so we need to go around to this elevator and then go up here to these buildings up here, which we have not been to. We've been past the elevator into the Marauder Stronghold. That's where we found Lucky Montoya over here somewhere, and Charles from accounting. That was interesting. So we're headed for, yeah, the elevator. And there's stuff, of course. Do we go this way, or do we go? No. Wait, yeah, we do have to. What's this way? Oh yeah, that's actually more, yeah. Worker domiciles. I have to go past the worker domiciles. So we could probably just skip those for now. We fought them already. Of course, these guys are back. Oh my god. Bodies flying around.
We did it.
That we did. I was worried those things were gonna join in. Yeah, these colossi, whatever, they take a long time to go down. Now, we've already explored this area, so there should be nothing new, okay, except for, I guess, this stuff. And enemies. Was there a one of these vending machine? No. I think over here, maybe? Where's the other one? Oh crap. Ah, I'm reloading, damn it. Ouch. Yeah, I'm hurt, alright. There's a lot of them. Ow.
Everyone all right?
Got him. Thank you very much. Just trying to get to the elevator. What has this world come to? This is technically not even a world. I think it's an asteroid, but you know what I mean. There's more over there. Jeez. We've been here, so if there's a vending machine, it should be highlighted. No, nothing around here. Maybe we'll find one up top. You know, I'm wondering, what do we pick up? Because I'm... nothing much. Stop stomping around like that. You make me nervous. Okay. Elevator's here. Just got these guys between... Damn it, I can't hit that thing. Oh, I did hit something. Good. Good, 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 because I want to get to that elevator. Yeah, they're always using these maces. Almost exclusively, it seems. Missed that locker. Did I see something else? Because someone had picked up someone else. Okay. Well, I don't see him now. Have I been up here? Probably, yeah. Yeah, it seems I have. Okay. This is the elevator, I think. Looks like a structure that... Yeah. Would be elevator-y. Going up. We have not yet been up here, but the phonograph, or one of them, is close.
Easy does it.
Easy does it. Up here, I assume we'll be killing more marauders. Or maybe huge beasts. Could be that. I do not like the sounds. Let me check over here. See if there's anything tucked away. It's probably not. It's in there, though. Oh, okay. Yeah, I definitely hear that. Now, I think against those primals, if that's what those are. I think they are. I think we want to use plasma? I had so much trouble with those, I was like not making any damage at all to these things. So this is N-ray. Mind control. Did I have something like that? Finn's Force. Shock Cannon Ultra, maybe? The flamethrower didn't seem to do much. I really don't like these weapons. You seem to have to get really close with them. And that's when I die, when I get close to things. Oh, it's just a canid? The canids, I find, are not that bad. Of course. I don't think we've seen a canid charger before. I'm using that right. I think I'll try to just stick to my usual here. Or that works. That seemed to work pretty well. I love this thing. Thing is, it seemed to have like really hardly any effect on the primals. Just peek over here. Oh, this one. What goes around? Oh. What are these guarding, right? On the wall, too? Damn. Now you got me wondering what all these things are. They really want to stop someone from going this way for some reason. Oh. And I want to know why. What is so important? Oh, some buildings up here. Any more things on the wall?
I ain't think we're welcome here, Captain.
It's almost like they're trying to send a message, don't you think?
We're not welcome anywhere here, so what's the difference? Dead person. Okay, nobody in here. We got something.
We call them marauders. Like they have some kind of group identity. They don't. The name was coined in Edgewater, I think. One of the towns first hit by the Adrenatime crisis. A lonely spacer's choice outpost on the edge of a barren sea. A prime place for the company to test a disastrous new product. When the town started fraying at the edges, hardly anyone else in the colony noticed. Just like Lucian planned. I read the reports. Every missing person. Every unexpected death. A town already teetering on the edge, and Adrenatime shoved it off a cliff.
Alright, so that's that. Oh, it's not even one of them. That's... okay. That's not the phonograph. The phonograph is, Roscoe. So this is just another photograph from, Olivia Ambrose, obviously.
When does a man become... marauder. People talk about them as if they've transformed, like they've mutated. I see it in the Aetherwave broadcasts, read it in the papers. But beneath their masks, they're only people. Dangerous people, with a terrible illness, but people still. When we call a man a marauder, have we given up on him? How do we know when he's become one? How can you decide to give up on someone? Have I given up on Harvey? Who does this suffering serve, I wonder? Spacer's choice?
Very good points, actually. Do they decide to be marauders, or... we... what was I stuck on? do we decide they're marauders? That is really interesting looking. So, we did find another rifle. Another Mark III light assault rifle, which is what I was looking for. Parvati has one. And Vicar Max, we're going to give him to upgrade from his Mark II. There we go. You have now been upgraded. I find a workbench. I'll tinker it up and make it even more deadly for Max here. Wow. Flamethrowers are heavy. Let's see. Oh, we got plenty to carry. Plenty more room. Can I check the lockers? Yeah. What's that? I'm not sure if that's some kind of beast or a machine making that sound.
I envy whoever had this post. Gazing at the stars through a telescope is quite a peaceful endeavor.
If we find anyone here, they're not going to be very peaceful, though. Maurice's research site. Doesn't seem to be anyone around. Oh, I can't go that way. Eustace Kim's datapad. Maurice, I've made my peace with the chemical waste pit. It is where I belong, I think, with the refuse and the dregs. The surface is distant to me, as distant as the cold stars, as distant as you are, and the rest of them. How do you fare, Maurice, up on your vaunted perch, when the shadow of the manufactory crown falls on you and your fine telescope? Do you think of me down here, in the dark, to any of you? My isolation has borne fruit. Propane, butane, ethane. These wild gases visit me in my dreams. They shift and morph, compress and expand. Gas now, then liquid, then gas again. They've whispered to me the trick of their metamorphosis, and I have bottled it as they taught me. Come down from the shadow of your manufactory, Maurice, down to the ravine, and they will teach you the trick too. Let us at last complete the package that I might finally ascend. All glory to the PET, Eustace. Was that guy down at... That's... moving. What the hell? That's freaky. Are these things keeping this? I don't know. It's like floating. So that's the building there that we came out of last episode. The Office of Creative Incubation? I have a feeling we're supposed to be finding something important around here, but I don't see anything. I'll start growling. I don't like that. All right. Oh, just gonna run back, hoping we've taken care of all the landmines.
Got it. Inside voices.
Thank you. Some kind of baddies. More canids. In the grass. I love this weapon. Just gotta say, I love this weapon. Up there is the thing. Executive suites. Phonograph is the word I was looking for. Anybody or anything else around? I'm stuck growling, I don't like that. Makes you think you're a rabbit, in which case you would attack. So this is where we came from. I think I'm just covering. Trying to be thorough here. Alright, so down here first. Excuse me. All loot must be looted. A train of time all over the damn place. Okay. Oh, jeez. Diane Schutz, final report. To the co-worker who finds this, given you're reading this, I'm likely dead. I'm very sorry about that. I'm also sorry Spacer's Choice had to send someone else to finish my assignment. As of the moment I'm writing this, Charles Novak still possesses the express mail delivery prototype. I believe he's gone entirely mad. Oh, Charles McCounting, right? As he has abandoned his apartment and taken up with a group of marauders not far from here. Yeah, down below. Charles no longer recognizes me. He can't even recognize the Spacer's Choice jingle. When I sang it for him to try to coax him into a calmer state, he shot me in the arm. Don't blame him for that. If you're here to retrieve the prototype, here is what you should know. The prototype remains intact. The prototype has been modified to simultaneously fire multiple projectiles, and the original package housing chamber appears to have been replaced with an explosive payload. Please know that it did not sanction these modifications, nor do I approve of setting fire to company correspondence. Charles's depravity knows no bounds. The original package was only intended to deliver... The original prototype, sorry, was only intended to deliver packages more quickly, nothing more, and I'd sooner die than see it used for violence. To that end, I'm going to try to recover the prototype for Charles, from Charles. Should I fail, please remember me fondly despite my incompetence. Faithfully, Diane Shoot. What was it? But explosive payload. Is that? Hold on. Is it this? Yeah. Originally designed as an experimental mail delivery tool, this launcher was listed as a failed prototype and forgotten. With its recent discovery and retrofitting, its homing pneumatic tubes are now filled with explosives to deliver death rather than envelopes. Alright, so we got that weapon. Alright, so we're going up there, but first I'm looking around down here. Remolded power helmet. The photograph is close. It's in there. Lots of stuff. Mag pick in the garbage. There's the thingy. Get it in a second. It's a lot of noise.
Dr. Ambrose, tell me about Adrena Time. What does it do?
Hasn't Clarence already dumped a pile of promotional materials on your head?
Where's the fun in that? My listeners want to hear it in your own words.
It's an injectable drug that improves a patient's speed, awareness, mental acuity, and endurance. In moderation, Adrena Time will uplift the laboring classes by strengthening their minds and work ethic.
That's quite the mission. What's driving this vision of uplift?
I am a solutions-oriented woman. I see a problem, and I am moved to solve it. Poverty is one such problem. Through science, I believe we can improve the poor, and in so doing, improve Halcyon.
Well, it didn't quite turn out that way, did it? All right, so we found two out of four of these. OCI upper exterior. That door we have yet to go in. Not a crack shot anymore, are you? Now I didn't is another way in there, because I did not see that. I did not go out. Did not see an exit that brought us out this way. So these clues are nowhere near. There's one all the way over here. There's one at the mines here, which you've not been to. And what? By Maurice's research site? Oh, are you kidding me? We have to go back there. We have to go back there. I knew I missed something. I knew there was something important there. That goes back towards the secret hideout, looks like. Man. Oh, I got a letter. Got a letter. Old fashioned. Teammate's letter. Barton. Thanks for subbing in for Lenader. Priantha scored one hell of a body goal on us last week, and in the process we tore our goalie a new Wednesday zone. Lenader's fault. Hullhead thinks he's Bertie Holcomb himself. Seeing as you just finished a night shift, Frida's letting us swing by her place to get some Adrena time from her stash so you don't nod off mid-period, and to give you a little edge on Doc Priantha, if you catch my meaning. Trust me, you'll be glad for it. Back in 20, Tillman. Alright, so these guys are trying to get an edge in their sports. Activities? I saw something over here. A container or something, no? Alright, let's check in here and then we're gonna run back up there and then I can fast travel back here.